But then you have to place bets. Mm-hmm. So it sounds like you're placing them on software-defined and flash.
Yes.
Is it that simple?
We're placing those bets, and you know, we're definitely taking advantage of flash capability, not only within our flash system product, which I know my colleagues will talk more to you about today, but we're also infusing flash into our existing product lines. So our high-end storage, we shipped flash enclosures last year. So we think flash is a dominant hardware form factor for storage going forward. So yeah, we're placing these bets.
How does it, specifically with regard to Spectrum and software defined, how does it change the sort of resource requirements that you have as an executive, the skill sets that you need? Where do you obviously big company.
Yeah.
Can you talk about that challenge as a head of storage?
Right, we made some important organizational changes earlier this year where we actually brought together the storage capabilities that were in our traditional hardware unit with the storage capabilities in our software unit, and now we're an integrated unit. And that also gives us the advantage of an integrated sales force. And it brought a lot of software skills to our business where we now have a worldwide storage software sales force to enable us to embark on this agenda. And I think it's important to note that even with our flash offerings, the value of those offerings have largely always been about the state of innovation around the hardware engineering combined with really, really good software engineering in that box, in that system.
Well, it's interesting because I would imagine that most of the engineers in the hardware groups these days are software developers anyway.
Yeah, there's a lot of software in everything that we do. Yeah,
right.
Absolutely.
So the competition is always out there doing their thing. They always say, power the portfolio. I think you know what I'm talking about. Say EMC, for instance, they always talk about the portfolio storage. You guys are within a big, broader IBM. Big data's huge. You gotta be storage.
Yeah.
What are the key things that you're looking at in terms of new ground to take for the storage group? Obviously, you have the old spinning disk, you got flash, you got tape out there. Mm-hmm. We always joke, which one's going to die first, spinning disk or tape?
Yeah,
and
yeah,
tape's still hanging around.
Yeah,
but
but
you have to reinvent the future and create that and get in front of that next wave. What is that next wave for you guys?
Well, I definitely think that there's a tighter integration that needs to occur between the storage layer and many of these killer applications, if you will. And so to that end, last year we integrated and we shipped our software-defined storage with Big Insights, which is IBM's Hadoop-based distribution. We also see a lot of value with software-defined storage to improve the performance and economics of things like enterprise content management systems. So I think that there's a number of ISV applications and other what I call killer applications that are in this information management and analytics world, where this marriage of software-defined storage is going to be critical. The marriage of the two assets together will be critical.
So,
create solutions, exactly.
So the marketing buzzwords out there are data lake,
yeah.